Uganda is currently experiencing an upsurge in malaria cases. According to the Minister of Health figures, there was an increase in malaria cases from 100,000 in 2021 to 199,695 cases in 2022. This upsurge has been attributed to climate change. With this worrying trend, experts want government to advance the fight against malaria by promoting use of mosquito repellents alongside nets.
Mosquito repellents have a vital role in eradicating malaria because mosquito bed nets, they have got hindrance. Most of the people go to bed when they have been bitten by mosquitoes. So we are bridging the missing gap.
Repellent is that it is supposed to deter the mosquito biting you at that particular time. And most time when you see how people use repellents, they think they will use repellents when it is coming in the night. They even don't know at what time a mosquito starts what? Biting. So by the time you apply a repellent, already maybe the mosquito has what? Has bitten you. But they are also part of intervention.
Dr. Lawrence Mugisha from Makerere University, who doubles as the president of Lions Club, says time has come for the country to use multi-sectoral approach in fighting malaria by engaging communities.
So even when you have efforts like sleep under the mosquito net, some people are not able to sleep under the mosquito net, and yet the mosquitoes are still available and are able to transmit the what? And that's why we are saying controlling malaria is not only about money. It's not only about technology, it is about every Ugandan acknowledging that this thing is a problem with us, and we can take part and be responsible for controlling malaria.
As the country prepares to commemorate the World Malaria Day next week on 25th April, the Parliamentary Forum on Malaria has organized a malaria walk in Kampala to drum up awareness. Malaria remains the leading cause of morbidity and mortality rates in Uganda, killing over 50 people per day. The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, is expected to be the chief walker in the Sunday event.
We, the parliamentarians, together with the Lions, to come up with a walk is to actually create more awareness amongst ourselves, the development partners, the various civil society organizations and other stakeholders, the Ministry of Health, to create awareness that we have a target to hit. We have to eliminate it by 2030.
Dr. Timothy Batua, the chairperson of the Parliamentary Forum on Malaria, says the walk is going to bring together experts to review Uganda's path in the fight against malaria to see whether the target to eliminate malaria by 2030 can be realized.
When we talk of awareness, is to identify what we've been doing and assess whether we are doing it right or we need to improve or do it in a different way.
I think this time we need to work together with government, with all stakeholders, to ensure that we create awareness and to ensure that people get to know that malaria is real and it can kill. So if that can be achieved, then definitely our people will be able to take precautions and be able to prevent malaria.
In this sense, some members of parliament want government to involve them in the fight against malaria, especially in aspects of distributing mosquito nets and raising awareness.
The government may not directly use the members of parliament to distribute mosquito nets, but they need to be involved so that when these mosquito nets go to the districts, members of parliament are informed and they are brought on board to mobilize communities.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.